Well, Mr. Montazeri, actually stood against Imam Khomeini in the early days of the revolution too.
Well, many thought he would be the successor.
True, but it was Imam himself who put him aside. Well, I mean, he stands opposed to the system. He is considered as an opposition in Iran. From our viewpoint, what he says does not have any legal credibility. It's his opinion. But there's a law that defines things in our country. And if we take the law out, there's nothing left. When you say why the judicial system cannot or will take charge of these affairs, well, the question is, I mean, if not the judiciary, then who? Which institution, which body is supposed to carry through with these issues? We did condemn what happened.
You condemned what?
Every conflict and clash there was. Some of our fellow citizens were killed, about 30 people. Most of them actually were supporters of the government. Ordinary people who were in their stores, in their cars, who were shopping, who were on their way to a party. These were people who supported the government. Even Mr. Ruhol Amin, who lost his son, regrettably, is one of my own friends.
I know.
We're friends. However, this was a pre-stage program, and it was encouraged by some people. And an effort was made to put a positive spin on an illegal act. And some British politicians, as well as some American politicians, and some media were also, biased in trying to turn something, an illegal act, into a legal act. And that was not right. I mean, the purpose of elections is to make sure no one goes on the streets.
The purpose of election is to make sure no one goes on the streets?
Yes, because the result of elections is meant to demonstrate that the rule of the majority is what carries through. Now, without elections, then people will have to go on the streets and fight with one another to decide who wins, and whoever wins on that street fight will then take over the country. But that's exactly why we have elections, in order to channel the process through of popular vote to decide who should lead a country. And the person who wins the majority will lead the country. I mean, in the end, in any elections, there's always a majority and a group that is in the minority. Now, the group in the minority can't simply question why they're in the minority and decide to go on the streets and break windows and set bags on fire, or even set garbage cans on fire. I mean, what kind of methodology is that? It's kind of, I would say, despicable.
Meryl Streep, Warren Buffett, Serena Williams, Bruce Springsteen, Adam Sandler, Kobe Bryant, Judd Apatow. The world's most interesting people are on Charlie Rose, and Charlie Rose is now on Bloomberg Television. Join Charlie each weeknight for riveting interviews, laugh out loud anecdotes, and unexpected revelations. Don't miss Charlie Rose, weeknights at 8 p.m. and 10 p.m. Eastern on Bloomberg Television.